Good evening.
Good evening.
And welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school, but it's not a church. And neither are we affiliated with any church or religious organization. The school is a non-profit, non-denominational religious and scientific research organization dedicated to proving the existence of Yahweh Elohim and the operation of the eternal pattern, purpose, and plan operating from eternity until this present day. Now, this school is the result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kennedy, in the state of Ohio in the year 1931. We were incorporated in the state of California in the year 1958. Since that time, we have established branch schools throughout the United States and various parts of the world. The Ontario branch school was established in May of 1988. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you school officials. The dean of the Ontario branch school is Dr. Joe Williams, and the president is Dr. Reginald Thomas. Now, at this school, we use and teach by the true and original name of the Heavenly Father, the Word of Son, and the Holy Spirit, which are contained in the original Hebrew text. The true name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and has been improperly substituted by Lord. The true title for the Word of Son is Elohim. It has also been improperly substituted by God. And the true name for the Holy Spirit, manifested in or out of a physical body, is Yahshua. It has been erroneously substituted by Jesus Christ. Lord and God are titles, and they are not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8:5, that there are Lord's many and God's many. We now know each Lord must have a name, and each God must have a name also. Elohim is a title, but unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. This means Elohim is a title that our Creator chose for himself. Jesus is a name, but Jesus is an erroneous name. A minor investigation on your part in a good dictionary or encyclopedia would prove that the Hebrew language, the Greek language, or the Latin language have any characters or letters in their alphabet that would produce a sound that is made by this letter J. Neither was there a letter J in the English language until some 1400 years after the Messiah's death. Therefore, since it is that Jesus and Jehovah are impossible renderings for the true and original name of our Heavenly Father and His Son. Now, Christ is a title just like Lord and God. Yahweh is pure spirit, and this state is incomprehensible, inscrutable, and indiscernible. He is the ultimate source, substance, limits and bounds of everything. We have Yahweh symbolized on this chart as a cloud. Yahweh is not a cloud. He merely chose cloud to symbolize himself because a cloud has no particular or descriptive shape and form. Now we draw this cloud around the edges of this chart to show you that everything on this chart is within the cloud. In like manner, everything in the universe abides within the pure spirit state of Yahweh. Yahweh, knowing that man cannot perceive of him in this pure spirit state, took on shape and took on form right within himself as Elohim. This is the Word of Son, a super incorporeal being that is having the shape and form of a man, but without flesh and blood. And this shape and form can only be seen in a divine vision and understood in a divine revelation. Now later on, the self-same spirit manifested himself in a physical body and walked the earth plane as Yahshua the Messiah, who the world calls Jesus Christ. Now there's only one name given us salvation, and we all must know this name. So the simple yet intelligent question we should ask ourselves is, what was the name of the Savior during the time he walked the earth plane? A further understanding of this name and title could be had by reading the preface of the Holy Bible. Now also in the school, we teach by divine pattern of the universe. It is called a divine pattern because it is Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh Elohim, that the children of Israel, up out of Egypt, he called Moses on top Mount Sinai and showed him a tabernacle pattern in a vision. He instructed Moses to build one, exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. Now this pattern consists of a most holy place, a holy place, and court round about. These three compartments make up the one tabernacle pattern. Also in the school, we go forth to prove that everything in the universe moves and operates according to the structure and function of the threefold tabernacle pattern, and absolutely nothing escapes this pattern. Now the 10 primary constitutional objectives or aims, this is as follows. Number one, is to help you find and know Yahweh or Elohim as really is and actually exists. Two, is to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah, without distinction of race, nationality, creed, sex, caste, or color. Third is to investigate the unexplained spirit law, or so-called law of nature, and the powers latent in man. Fourth is to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures, comparative religions, psychology, philosophy, modern practical, and occult science. Fifth is to extirpate current superstitions, skepticism, and ignorance. Sixth is to learn and know and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose through the dispensation and ages. Seventh is to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the dragon, or Satan and his demons, operating the mystery of iniquity on earth through the dispensation of time. And eighth is to earnestly contend for the common salvation of faith that was once delivered unto the sons or children of Yahweh. And ninth is to make known that Yahweh, from the beginning ordained, there is no other name given among men whereby man must be saved, save in the name of Yahshua the Messiah. And tenth is to inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah with the hope of immortal glorification in the newer state. Our mantra is peace, and our slogan is speak the truth. This evening, our prayer by Dr. Irene Ramirez, star of our class. Our scripture lesson will be Galatians, the 6th chapter, and our scripture reader will be Dr. Eric Green.
Thank you once again, Yahweh Elohim, for gathering us here today so we can learn about you through your purpose, pattern, and plan. And we hope we get something out of it tonight. We all ask this in your son's name, Yahshua. Let's all say hallelujah.
Good evening, class.
Good evening.
Tonight's scripture lesson will be taken from Galatians, the 6th chapter, on page 255 of your Holy Name Bible. Galatians chapter 6. Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of the Messiah. For if a man think himself to be something, when he is nothing, he deceiveth himself. But let every man prove his work, and then shall he have rejoicing in himself alone, and not in another. For every man shall bear his own burden. Let him that is taught in the word contribute unto him that teacheth in all good things. Be not deceived. Elohim is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the spiritual shall of the spirit reap life everlasting. And let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap, if we faint not. As we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them who are of the household of faith. Ye see how large a letter I have written unto you with mine own hand, as many as I desire to make a fair show in the flesh. They constrain you to be circumcised, only lest they should suffer persecution for the cross of the Messiah. For neither thy themselves who are circumcised keep the law, but desire to have you circumcised, that they may glory in your flesh. But Yahweh forbid that I should glory, save in the sacrifice of our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah, by whom the world is crucified unto me, and I unto the world. For in the Messiah, Yahshua, neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creature. And as many as walk according to his rule, peace be on them, and mercy, and upon the Israel of Yahweh. From henceforth let no man trouble me, for I bear in my body the mark of the Savior, Yahshua. Brethren, the grace of our Savior, Yahshua Messiah, be with you, be with your spirit. I just read Galatians chapter 6.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you. All right, we all know tonight's our workshop night. Without further ado, our first speaker will be the Dean, Dr. Joe Williams.
Thank you. Good evening, class.
Good evening.
I'd like to extend a nice welcome to Eric Green. It's good seeing you again. And seeing you for such a long time, you don't realize how much joy it brings to my heart to see you back in class. I just hope that something is said here to inspire you to want to come and to learn about Yahweh's purpose. And as always, our goal is to help everyone take off this flesh. Mm-hmm. And what I want to try to do tonight is try to, you know, help us all take off some of this flesh.
All right.
Now, are there any questions before we get started? And I also want to say this too. I want you to take word back, because it's already been brought out that Pomona is shutting their class down for a few weeks. Mm-hmm. And I just hope the word is out that they're welcome to come, mm-hmm. which I think they already know that. Mm-hmm. But I hope some, if not all, come and sit and study with us for a few classes, and maybe that would help inspire some of us to kind of come together. But I just want to make sure we take that word back. Now, are there any questions about anything before we get started? Okay. Any questions? This is question and answer time. So if there are any questions, we can address some of those now.
Well, I have a question.
Go ahead.
The other day when Reggie was up, oh no, I was at the other class.
It doesn't matter.
Well, anyway, at least he's here, he can answer my question. He was talking about, maybe he was here, it doesn't matter. He was talking about that how in as time changes, things change for organizations, you know, like our organization. I think you were talking about the...
Constitution?
Yeah, the Constitution and the... Weren't you talking about the introduction?
Yeah. Oh, the moderation?
Yeah, it wasn't the moderation. It was the Constitution.
Because about the Constitution and Dean, the founder said, and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah. And how it's been changed since then.
Yeah.
Was I dreaming?
Go ahead.
Let me find my paper. I'll be reading.
Yep.
So my question is, are you saying that in reference to maybe we should change our constitution?
Okay. No, what I was saying was this. In I forget what year, but it must have been in 1982, because that's when Pomona changed their constitution. Okay, at that particular time, Leonard Snellbaker was on the board of trustees. So every month, they had a board meeting in L.A.
But you mean, Pomona didn't change the constitution?
Wait, I'm gonna explain it to you. And I used to go, he used to take me to the meetings with him, because I was the president of the Pomona class. So he decided not to go anymore, and he made me his proxy. So he told me whatever I felt when they had to take a vote, he said whatever I felt like, that's what I voted for. Well, coming up, they were talking about, I guess they had the guy there, his name was Ryan. He was, I don't know if he was an attorney or a study interviewer.
Attorney.
Yeah. He was an attorney, yeah, Ryan. Okay, and so.
Bill Ryan.
Bill Ryan, that's his name, yeah, Bill Ryan. So it was, they wanted to make some changes in the Constitution. And what I was saying is, it's just like the DMV. Every year the DMV changes the rules and the laws of the land, the way you can drive. Mm-hmm. One time you was able to drive at 55, right. Then they made it 65. So you can't say, well, this year I can do it, but last year I couldn't do it. You know, so what they wanted to do is change some things in the Constitution. They said the laws of the land were changing. Mm. Or in other words, when you have a nonprofit organization, there's certain rules and regulations you have to follow. And so some changes were going to be made. Well, Leonard Snellbaker, Willie Jones, and Michael Ali did not want to change the Constitution. They said Dr. Kennedy's Constitution was good enough for them. So Willie Jones and Dr. Snellbaker pulled out of IDMR. Willie Jones changed the name to the Institute of Divine Reality.
That's correct.
And Leonard just changed it to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research of Pomona Incorporated, because he did not want to change Dr. Kinley's constitution. Mm-hmm. So now, what I was saying was this, and you know in Pomona I have brought up about not having a dean, and they say, we don't need a dean, right? Okay, now, all I'm telling you is what Dr. Kinley stated at the first business meeting in 1967, at the first international convention, what he said. See, now remember, the moderator says in Pomona, good evening, welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research of Pomona Incorporated, a non-profit religious and scientific research organization.
Yeah.
Then they say, in order to preserve the integrity of Dr. Kinley's vision, the Pomona School incorporated in California in 1982. I'm saying, wait a minute. Number one, you think you're alone and by yourself. I asked them, who is your parent school? Our parent school was founded in the state of Ohio in the year of 1931. So that means you have another school that you're associated with. But you want to make yourself separate. You cannot make yourself separate when you have a parent school. And then if you're going to preserve the integrity of Dr. Kinley's vision, then that means you have to teach according to his vision.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Not according to what Leonard Snellbaker said. Mm-hmm. That was not Dr. Kinley's vision. Leonard did not teach me that. From 1973 to 1976, he taught me Kinley's vision to the T. He was one of the best in it. And he told me, he said, son, remember the former things of old. That's why I still go over there, because of what he told me. And before he took off the flesh, from what Afonzia Macklin told me and Pamela Snellbaker told me, I'm not going to use the exact words he told them, but he said, I'm sitting there in a wheelchair and I got a diaper on, and I'm doing number one and number two on myself, and I told them people I was Yahweh, he said, I taught some things wrong. And he said, I wish I had time to go back and straighten them out. Pamela said, do you want me to bring some students and you can tell them? He said, no. They know. They who? Well, I'm one of the they that knows. And I was his president. And he had a lot of trust in me. Because he sent me to different conventions because he knew I would bring him back a true report. So that's why I stay there and I say the things that I say, and I take the flack from the people. Where I used to let it get to me, but now I've learned, don't let it get to me. Because I found out that Yahweh has a purpose, a pattern, and a plan. And when you understand what's going on, you can see it. Now what I was saying was this, about a dean, and I told them this, and you know. I said, I don't care whether you have a dean or not, but don't tell me you don't need one. That's what I said, and this is why I said that. Alphonsia Macklin wrote this paper. It's called About Progressive Revelations. He wrote it to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research, International Executive Board of Trustees, and he wrote this to him in August of 2003. But on page two, he says, gentlemen and brethren, I beseech you to analyze, be aware, and assume the responsibility and charge given to you of our founder. Then he put this. This is taken from the 1967 convention business meeting. So it is record of this, that they have this on record in LA. Now, there is a president in the states. And their job is it as it is in the Constitution, in Dr. Kelly's Constitution. For Dr. Gross and Dr. Harris in each one of the states in which we operate and the Board of Trustees that you have there. Now I told you, Leonard was on the Board of Trustees. Then he says, and the deans in the state in which we operate, their job and their business is to see to it that the gospel is preached and to make sure that it is the gospel. I just thought it was my duty to make that real good crystal clear and to help with the work. That's what the founder said. He said that's the responsibility of a dean, is to make sure that the gospel is being preached and it is the gospel. Now see, gospel and glad tidings mean the same thing. Good news, no bad news. It means good news. Now, only reason people change in other schools when you see glad tidings in the Bible, and Pomona would get offended, because Eric would read over here, and then he would read the scripture in Pomona, and when it said glad tidings, he would say gospel, and they would get pissed. And I told Eric, just say glad tidings. Like the book says. But the reason Dr. Kelly told him that is because the Catholic Church came out with a newsletter called The Tidings. And he didn't want nobody to think that we were associated with the Catholic Church. But see, you can't tell them that. Glad Tidings, that's our newsletter. That's it, the Glad Tidings. And you know that, the Glad Tidings, read the Glad Tidings. And I'm saying, no, read Dr. Kelly's lectures. Learn his lecture first before you learn what Leonard was saying in it, because you did not understand what the man said. Example, he said this in the newsletter. This is not your Savior. People still don't understand that. No, that ain't your Savior. That's not your Savior. He was correct. But now this is what he said in the newsletter. Dr. Kelly showed us and proved to us that Yahshua the Messiah is the Savior. He said, but the reason I say, Leonard Snellbaker, the reason I say Yahshua is not your Savior, this is what Leonard said 30 years ago. Your Savior and my Savior is Henry Clifford Kinley. Had he not come in, what would we know? Now that's what he meant by what he put in that newsletter. Leonard knew who walked the Palestine and Judean hills. He knew that was Yahshua. He knew that. Now you'll go over there right now and they'll tell you Emmanuel walked the Palestine and Judean hills. When you read in the Bible, Isaiah 7:14, Matthew 1 something, and Isaiah 8 something, the only place you're going to find Emmanuel. That's who was in Yahshua. Emmanuel. That's Elohim with us. That's how simple it is. All I'm saying is, don't say one thing that you do and do the opposite. Now when you do that, then people label you as a hypocrite. Because you say one thing and do another. Like I said, our parents' school, who's your parents' school?
LA.
Your parents' school is LA. Mm-hmm. The one he started. So don't tell me you're alone and by yourself. You're not alone. See? The second name of the school, to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah. Without distinction of race, creed, sex, caste, or color, or what damn school you go to. That ain't got nothing to do with it. The Holy Spirit is the teacher. And when you find out that, that's why I tell them, don't tell me Leonard set you free. No man has set you free.
Right.
Joe cannot set me free.
Right.
He can explain things to me. Now, if his spirit and my spirit bear witness, then I'm okay. The same thing Leonard Snellbaker told me is the same thing Joe Williams told me. You put Yahweh first, and you ain't got to worry about nothing. And that's what I tell Eric. The man is suffering right now. You put Yahweh first.
Right.
You ain't got nothing to worry about then. See, I didn't really believe that at first. But once you put your faith in that, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
That's right.
See? We can't see Yahweh, but we know he exists. And we know that he exists in us. And all we have to do is be obedient to what he tells us, and everything will be added. Everything will be added to us.
That's right.
And that's why I deal with Pomona. My love is in Pomona too. Anywhere I'm going, I'm a member of that school. If I go to Banning, I'm a member of Banning. If I go to LA, I'm a member of LA. Because we're all supposed to be in Yahshua the Messiah. And we can learn from everybody. But when you want to give praise and honor and glory to a man, you're wrong. Because that's not what the man stood for. And like I always told him all the time, you thought Leonard was so smart. Leonard did not hold a candle to Johnny's daddy. You understand what I'm saying? I know the power that man had. Because he put his hands on me. And I had migraine headache so bad one time I tried to take my life. That man set me in a chair and worked on me, and I never had another migraine headache in my life. And he told me things. He sure did. I knew the power that was in him. How did I know who he was? Because according to this pattern, he was Dr. Kennedy's messenger. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. Harris was his warrior.
That's right.
Drew Lord was his messenger. And he was Yahweh sitting in the middle dictating to them boys. And he got Harris still around doing what he wanted to do. And he had Dennis doing exactly what he wanted to do. Any problem that was in the school?
Send out Dennis.
Johnny, no.
Yeah, send him out.
Let's go. I got to go. The boss want me to go straighten it out. That's who straightened it out. Dennis Drulor. And that's what I always said. That's the man who had the smarts. You see what I'm saying? So see, we can be fooled. And that's what that adversary wants you to do. See, Dr. Kinley said, he already waiting for you when you come sit down in this chair. He already there. You sit right down on him. Boom. And he gonna say, let me see what I can do with Maria tonight. Let me see if I can change her mind. Now, he ain't gonna change my mind no more. Mm-mm. I'm done with that. I keep my eye on the prize. And that's what I try to teach people. Don't let nothing upset you. And it's gonna try. And it's gonna come in there sometimes too. Because you can't always deal with it. But you know, Yahweh knows your heart and he knows your mind. And that's what he looks at, your heart, your mind. And he will give you the strength.
That's right.
He will give you the strength. Like I told Eric coming to class, I said, man, I'm tired all the time. You know, I just don't feel like, man, I feel great again right now. Every time I get up here, I feel great. I feel like I can go out there and run a mile. But once I get out of here, you talk about walk around the corner, man, I'm going to be like this. But see, but when I get up here, talking about what's real, my mind ain't there no more. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You're taken away from this flesh.
Yeah.
And you're dealing up here with the Father.
That's right.
See, so I hope I answered your question about what I was talking about with the Constitution. But see, it's like I said, and Johnny knows that too, the laws of the land and the laws of nonprofit organizations when things got to change. You have to change with the times. Mm-hmm. Some people don't want to change. But you have to change according to the law.
Yeah.
And that's what I was talking about. I don't care whether you ever have a dean. Just don't tell me you ain't supposed to have one, but you gonna tell me you believe what Henry Clifford Kinley said. No, you don't. I'm gonna tell you, you're a liar to your face. You do not believe what that man taught. Because he laid it out for you. It was read the other last week out of that Vision Panther. The last time he said, man, what would you do with that which I showed you? He said, teach your people your will, Joshua. And he said, that's what I'm endeavoring to do by the book entitled Elohim, the archetype or original pattern of the universe. That is his vision. And if you don't teach that, far as I'm concerned, the hell with you. Because you're teaching a lie. Mm-hmm. That's all you got to teach is what the man said as easy as 1, 2, 3. Mm-hmm. But we don't say, no, it's got to be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. It can't be that easy. Yes, that easy. It's so simple, a fool cannot err. Mm-hmm. So if you're erring, what's worse than a fool? I don't know. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, an idiot? Mm-hmm. A stupid fool? Mm-hmm. But see, it's so simple. And that's what deceives the people. All you got to do is go by exactly what he told you. That's why we always tell you, you never knew nothing about the Bible till you came in here and you read right in the beginning. It says, in Genesis 1:1, in the beginning God created. You never asked the question, in the beginning of what? Mm-hmm. And when you found out what that was, when it took you all the way back down here to Moses,
yeah,
and found out what Moses saw and all, you said, wow, what is this? They don't teach that out there in the world. Mm-hmm. But that's the simplicity of the gospel. Yeah. So I hope I answered your question.
Yes, I'm glad you said something about having a dean or not having a dean, because I was in Florida.
About who?
About having a dean or not having a dean. And
so, uh-huh.
Because when I was in Florida a couple of years ago, I was with the Haverlys. The Haverlys that
yeah.
were originally from New York,
uh-huh.
under Dr. What's his name? Well, it doesn't matter. The doctor, the dean of New York.
Uh-huh.
And we were talking, and we would have like a class like every night. You know, I was there like for a month.
Mm-hmm.
And we were talking about, he was asking me questions about our school in Pomona and what happened. He wanted to know like what happened, why did we pull out of the, you know, the mother school. And he asked me who was the dean of your school. I told him we didn't have a dean, that we had just the president and she was running the school and we seemed to be running okay.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that the gospel is holding its integrity with us. You know, we're not changing it from what I can see, I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so he said, well, if you're incorporated, you can get away with not having a dean, but you should have a dean. And that's when he told me that. But
and see, and that's the only reason why I was reading to you what the one who had the vision said. Now, he's the one who started this organization. Yeah. Now, that's what he said. Now, Ontario didn't have a dean for how long?
Oh, about 4 or 5 years.
4 or 5 years till he stepped up.
Did he get
so you telling me Yahweh can't raise nobody up in your organization to be that?
I believe that we could or he could, but...
But don't say you don't need it.
Yeah, okay.
That's all I'm saying. I don't, whether you have it or not, I don't care. But don't tell me you believe in his vision and then you say, I don't have to do that. Well, then you got to tell me you don't have to go by the pattern either.
Yeah,
you see? You don't have to go by that either. See? Just like they say these charts. These charts ain't it. Why ain't they it? These charts ain't nothing but pictorial illustration of Bible stories. Read all the scriptures on each one of these charts. And that's all it is. So you need the charts. This is what Dr. Kinley said on the tape. He says it's a physical and mental impossibility for you to believe in something you know nothing about. He said that's why we made these charts. A physical and mental impossibility for you to believe in something you don't know nothing about. See, when you don't investigate what the founder said, anybody can fool you.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I'm not against Leonard.
On the contrary.
He taught me.
That's right.
That's why I'm the way I am today, baby.
Right.
He told me, don't you take a back seat to nobody.
That's right.
And I don't.
That's right.
I don't take a back seat to nobody. I know what I'm talking about.
Come on,
that's why I stand up there and do what I do over there.
Tell them.
They don't mess with me. Don't mess with me. You better know where you're coming from. Because I chew you up and spit you out. Not because I know so much, but I know enough what I've been taught. And I stand firm and solid in that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm firmly rooted. I don't care how hard the wind blow. It ain't blowing me out of the ground. You see what I'm saying? And then some of them know that. And let me tell you something else. I'm on tape. Danny Morales knows the truth and he won't teach it. I'm telling you what I know. He knows. He'll tell you this too. It wasn't no sex in the garden. The way it was taught. He'll tell you that too. He told it to me in one of, he told it to us in one of them Friday night classes. I have to believe what the founder wrote. You see the changes it make when you read what the founder said? Just like I told you, we had a class there one Friday. Kavon was reading, and this is what it said. It said, when Yahweh gave Moses, Yahweh, he gave him Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua. They didn't even know Yahshua was back there. She stopped reading and said, oh, Reggie, that's where you got that from. I said, I don't tell you nothing except what the founder said. Now, why ain't they using that? Because Leonard said his name was Emmanuel. And what did Leonard do? He named his son David Emmanuel. And he said, when I die, that's who is going to take my place. David Emmanuel. He had a class, right? People was going to his class. They stopped going to his class and come back to Pomona. He wouldn't even go to his daddy's class. But he was the one that was supposed to take over because it was taught from the floor that Dr. Kinley came in to set up Leonard. Robert Samuels taught that. I told him, man, you're crazy. But see, now he's starting to change a little bit. See, that's why when he was on the Florida, was you there last Wednesday?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. Who was on the Florida?
Last Wednesday, Robert Samuels was on the floor.
Oh.
In Pomona.
They,
he got on the floor and said that he was up because of something I said. Because I said that he said, Dennis said, if they didn't teach blood, butter, spirit 40, that they didn't get on the floor no more for 2 or 3 years. I told him that Dr. Kinley sent out 7 deans first. He had to make sure those deans were qualified and knew the basic fundamental principles of this gospel.
That's right.
So when they got up, they had to teach a certain way. And when he knew that they were taught that certain way, okay, you can go to Alabama. You can go to New York. You go out there and start a school in Banning. See, you go to Chicago. He knew they were qualified because he didn't want you out there in the name of the Institute and you don't know what you're talking about.
Right, that's right.
He wanted to make sure you were qualified in what you knew. Mm-hmm. See, but then Robert gonna say, well, he already knew that. He already knew a whole lot of stuff. Okay? Because everything was taken care of back here in the realm of eternity. But you don't understand that. He knows when you're coming in and when you're going out. You don't. So you're going to make the best between those two dots. But he knows when you're going out. See, so you can't use that. Well, he already knew that who he was going to send. Well, why didn't he just say, well, you go, you go, you go, you go, you go, and you go. And you know what? Matter of fact, all you people got to do is just stay at home. Because I just give it to you. That ain't how it works. Mm-hmm. That ain't how it works. You got to go through some of the same stuff that prophets went through back here. You got to go through the same thing. And that's why I do what I do. Because I'm motivated to do it. I've tried not to do it. And I've suffered for that. I told my wife on many occasions, I will never step another foot in that door at Pomona. Next thing I know,
you find yourself walking right in. Thank you.
Find myself walking right in. See what I mean?
Been there, done that.
Because I'm not running no show.
Uh-huh. That's right.
I thought I was. I thought I can change your mind. No, I can't change your mind.
No.
But I can put it out there.
Yeah.
Now it's up to you if you want to
take
it.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. See, it's up to you if you want to take it.
Right.
See, we done invited Pomona. Let's come together. Mm-hmm. You know how strong we can be? Woo! With what's going on over in here? Oh man. We can be so strong. But no. Oh no. Leonard wouldn't have that. Oh, you'd be surprised what Leonard wouldn't have. Mm-hmm. He would love that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy, he would love it. And I know that.
Oh, hell yeah.
You see, let me tell you something. I don't know if you know this or not. When I was asked to come over here and be a president, I took that to what I call the so-called elders of Pomona. And Danny Morales was one of them. You want to know what he told me? He said, if you don't accept it, I will be very disappointed in you. Oh, you didn't know that, huh?
If you don't accept what was he specifically?
Being the president over here in Ontario.
Oh, okay.
He would be very disappointed in me for not helping the brethren. You think he told the class that? No. You see? He didn't tell the class that, but he told me that. Lady P told me too. Yeah, you gonna do that. You see? But they didn't tell nobody that. Yeah, he would have been very disappointed if I would have said no. Wow. You see what I mean? There's a lot of things people don't know. So many things people don't, but they think they know everything. See, they forget who was in Pomona when it first got started. The Banning people.
Mm-hmm.
The Dean of Banning right now, Pat Nelson. Mm-hmm. You can go up to her and you know what she'll tell you? She said when Dr. Kinley sent Leonard out there to teach us in Banning, she said if that man teach you wrong, I'll be to see him. And guess what she told me? He never came.
That's right.
You used to go out there too, huh?
That's right, uh-huh.
And they can tell you some stories about Banning too, boy. They can tell you about some people who came in class and walked out the door and disappeared. A man, yeah. Mm-hmm. Wonder he just disappeared. The Lord can tell you about a wreck they was in. Went right through a car. All you gotta do is ask and she'll tell you. Sure did. It's a whole lot of stuff. You see what I'm saying? So people just don't know. But they think they know everything because they came on the late end. See, they came when Pomona was 200 strong. Well, my brother Clancell thought Doc was Yahweh. And he had to have everything. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And Johnny's daddy tried to warn Leonard about he was giving the boy too much power. I know what I'm talking about, people. Mm-hmm. I signed checks in the school. I know what was paid for the man. His rent, his car note, all his bills, and he was given a salary. This man was never given a salary. Mm-hmm. And he had the audacity to get on the floor and say, you cannot pay me enough to teach this gospel. Didn't know what he was doing. He was set up. He set him up.
Sure did.
You see what I'm saying? He set him up. But, and I try to tell people and they don't understand what I'm talking about because I tell them, I'm not talking about this.
There you go.
Thank you.
I'm not talking about the flesh.
That's right.
Before the man died, he let him know, I used you. And I'm letting you know before I take you out that you were wrong. And the man was thankful for that. He can die in peace. Them assholes, excuse me, they don't know. See, I'm telling you, they don't know. They think they know. They do not know. And Bobby Cherie jumped up and said what Pam said was a lie. You know how close he was with Pam.
Yeah, but what was the lie that she so-called told?
That what Doc, he said, he taught some things wrong. Oh. Cherie jumped up and said, she's lying. Now you know how close he was with Pam. See what I'm saying? But you got to see how Yahweh's working a purpose.
Right.
And when you finally understand that and find out he ain't talking about the flesh, that's what Job been trying to get up to see. I ain't talking about this flesh.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about this one you got up here.
There you go.
Mm-hmm.
That egotistical, misdirected SOB that we are. I told you I had to stop and think. I ain't no better than the man standing on the corner with a piece of paper saying, do, do, do.
Mm-hmm.
I was driving the other day, getting on the freeway, me and the grandbaby. I'm looking in the man's face. He got these pictures of a mother that died. And I see him all over the freeway with the same thing. I said, I ain't got no dollars. Chanel, you got any dollar bills? Because I said, no. So I just reached in my wallet and told him, come here, man. And I gave him a $5 bill, and he just looked at me like, wow. Wasn't nothing to me no more. I had a mama too. But my mama had burial insurance.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody don't. See, if something happens to me, they ain't got to go having a car wash or nothing like that for me. Because I got a life insurance policy. Western Southern Life. Remember him? I've been with him for over 20 years. Johnny knows. Yeah. He used to work for him.
But he sold me one too.
I got Western Southern Life.
I think I was his first client.
I got it on everybody, Johnny. And so if something happened, I even got it on my ex-wife. So if something happened to them, they can get a proper burial. You see what I mean? Because I don't think of myself anymore. That ain't what he came in for. He didn't come in for himself.
Mm-hmm.
He came in to redeem us. I'm a servant, and that's what I am. But I'm also a child of a king. Remember that song, Pam? I'm a child of a king.
Mm-hmm.
Yahshua, my Savior. Yahshua, my Savior. That's my Savior. In me, Yahshua the Messiah. Now, I ain't going to take up no more time. But I want Joe to get up here because some things that's going to come out of his mouth, I need it this evening.
Hmm.
So thank you.
I wasn't expecting all that.
Oh.
Are there any more questions since we got it out there like that? Okay. First Timothy, or the Second Timothy. I think it's First Timothy 4:1. I think that's what it is. Second Timothy 4:1. Now, let me say this before I continue and address some of the things he also said. Well, now, Terry, we started in 1988, and Tyrone Horn was the dean. And the reason why the school started, it's not because I wanted to be dean. I used to tell Tyrone, you're ready to be dean. If you decide to go out and start a school, I would help you. That's what I told him. We was going to Pasadena for years. And one day, out the clear blue moon, 2-3 years later, he walked through and said, Joe, we want to start a class. We're going to start a class in Ontario because they have a class in Pomona. That's the only reason we started in Ontario.
Oh, okay.
So I said, okay, well, we can start it at my house, okay, which is where we started. And when we started, it was myself, my son, Christopher, and my ex-wife, Danielle, who was, at the time, her and I were together, but yet separated in the same house. But she had an issue with the school. And the reason why she had an issue with the school, because she felt like that the class was a cult. And that's why she didn't go to class with me in Pasadena. And what I said was, class is not no cult. She got up in my face, she said, Joe, go look up the word cult. She knew how to deal with me. Well, she said that, well, one of the aims of the school, to do what?
Investigate.
To investigate.
Uh-huh.
What?
The unexplained
spirit law, the so-called law of the power of the man. The fourth aim is what? To encourage and promote the study of the scripture, compared to religions, right? Psychology, philosophy, modern, and occult sciences.
And occult science.
And one of the things in this school, we say over in 1 Thessalonians 5:21, you ain't got to get it, says what? Prove all things, right?
Right.
Hold fast to that which is good.
Yeah.
So when she said, Joe, go look up the word cult, then come talk to me. Well, of course, look up the word cult.
Cool.
Right now. She said, Joe, go look up the word cult. Why he's getting that. She functioned with a class at the house. She helped prepare everything. She cooked. We, in other words, everybody's welcome.
Right.
And Tyrone's family, which was his wife, Sandy. And his two kids. That was class. For a good while. Not one person from Pasadena ever come to visit or say hello or kiss my rumba bum bum. Not one. The only person who came down here was Noreen. And you guys know who she is, McClendon. And she left class too. Now, we had class for a good while, starting 1988, and then we moved over here to the Econo Lodge. At that time, it was called the Ontario Airport Inn.
Yeah.
Then it changed to the Connor Lodge.
Right.
Then it turned over back to, what was called now, it's called something else.
Ramada
Inn.
Yeah.
You see, now, when it came over to the Connor Lodge, my goodness, they changed management. And when they changed management, everything went wrong with that club. Two people committed suicide, all kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But class went on. Now, we moved from Ontario, we got put out, out the Econo Lodge. They said, gonna do some renovation.
Yeah.
What we didn't know was they were renovating us out.
Yeah.
They wanna have food and more of a, for their customers. To have like a continental breakfast.
Yeah. Right.
We didn't have, we thought they was gonna hook us up and put our charts up and all this stuff because that's the impression they gave us.
Yeah.
They just wanted us to get out so they can renovate.
Yeah.
And what they said was, we ain't got no place for you. We ain't got no contract. Yeah. So we couldn't do nothing else.
Yeah.
So we went and got this place over here at the theater. Oh, right over here is Bay Archibald. Oh. Archibald, we had a nice little place similar to this. Mm-hmm. Paid $1,000 a month. Matter of fact, March 20th, 1994, the Pomona branch came over and we fellowshiped in that place. Y'all remember that? And the first speaker was Dr. Dennis Drew Lord.
Oh, okay.
And the second speaker was Robert Harris that day.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And we had the Pomona class that we always do to come and sing. Mm-hmm. And they did. Now, what happened was the rent couldn't get paid. We could have had a hard time struggling to pay the rent. I only could do what I could do.
Mm-hmm.
To make a long story short, and I wasn't in the same place that I am in right now, mm-hmm. in terms of position. You with me so far? Mm-hmm. I was the president. Now, Tyrone felt like we did not support him mm-hmm. in the school. I know I supported him 100%. I know I did. I'm not guessing. I know I did.
Mm-hmm.
100%. Yes, sir.
Support, you mean stand behind him, or?
I stood behind him as the president, financially, and anything else.
Oh, okay, that was...
The only issue...
He wasn't getting paid enough for being dean?
So, the issues that we had sometimes, we didn't agree doctrinally.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that, there is something that was said that I had to stand up for the gospel. And some people felt like, well, Joe, you should. They didn't say that. But I could not stand and let things go that I could not let go. So that caused a little rift between us.
Mm-hmm.
Now, with that being said, and the rent, the issue with the rent, eventually he said one day he just shut it down. He went to the people, went and we left that place. And guess what? That class disbanded and we was at my house again.
Mm-hmm.
Six people came to class. And I said, look, there's a lot of schools all up and down the California I can go to. Mm-hmm. And at the time, I think, if I'm not mistaken, I think West Covina was still...
We visited...
Ontario.
Yeah.
Y'all was still going on. I said, there's plenty of schools. I can go to West Covina. Mm-hmm. I can go to Pomona. I can go to Banning. I can go anywhere I want. There's schools all up. But if you want to teach... If you want to have class, we can stay here and wait tea. We'll just keep rolling on. Otherwise, we can shut this thing down. Because mm-hmm. Tyrone quit. Now, what happened after that, six people, we grew. To the next thing I know, we had about 12, 13, 14 people in class coming under my house. We end up going back to the Econo Lodge. Mm-hmm. They changed managements again. And we got a nice, and matter of fact, negotiated a better deal this time than we was in there before.
Mm.
Now I was the president.
Mm.
Now, Fontana School had issues with us because we had no dean. We just had a president.
I mean,
I'm comfortable with the way things are. You know, I'm the president, we have a class, and open. That's it. Next thing I know, there's discussion in L.A. about those folks not having our dean down there, need a dean. And the person that's running the class down there is Joe Williams.
Mm-hmm.
So, they said, we need to do something about that. Well, I didn't think nothing of it. I don't care if we leave things just like they were. I felt the same way that Pomona felt.
Mm-hmm.
But they said, no, we got to have a dean. So I went to a meeting one day, and at the state office board meeting, you know, there was an issue about who's going to be the dean. Now, we had signed a petition. Matter of fact, by this time, I think Will was in class and a few. We had a few people. We signed a letter, wrote a letter to L.A. about what they want to do. And they all had a vote and decided that I would be the dean. Now, it don't make me no difference whether I'm the dean or not the dean. If Pomona and us want to get together, I don't have to be dean. I've said that more than once.
Right.
Dean don't mean squat.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
That even goes down here. So they don't want me to be dean here. I'm good with that too. Because
mm-hmm.
I don't need to be dean to be Yahweh. That's my point I'm trying to get you to see. I'm already Yahweh.
Right.
But I'm going to still come to class and support the class no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
On any level.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm all about the gospel, not the school.
Mm-hmm.
It's about the gospel being preached.
Right.
This is an avenue. I mean, this is a platform for us to come and learn about Yahweh and His purpose.
Mm-hmm.
So, we wrote a letter, and this is what they said, and everybody signed it. Get down to the meeting, Stephen, which was one of the class members, did a lot of talking, was very vocal, and they kind of liked him. They didn't really want me to be the dean, which was okay with me, but the letters had already said, everybody said what they wanted. Mm-hmm. So next thing I know, they called him to the sidebar, and they decided they're going to make him dean. Mm-hmm. Next thing I know, he comes to me a couple of days later and says, listen, man, they asked me to be the dean. I said, that's fine with me. You got my support 100%. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm okay with that. He said, I don't want you to be offended. I said, I'm not offended. Though I will tell you this, you did sign a letter saying you want me to be the dean. Mm-hmm. I said, but in that they chose you to be that, you got my support 100%. Because mm-hmm. it doesn't make me no difference. I still remain the president. Mm-hmm. I like being the president. Mm-hmm. You know, it's okay. So next thing I know, he was coming. He wasn't coming. He was coming. He wasn't coming. Now this guy only been in class for about a couple of years. He didn't know about no gospel. Didn't know about no Bible. But they chose him because they felt like he was strong, had a strong voice. Mm-hmm. They don't know nothing about him. Never met him a day in their life. But he felt like he should be the dean. Mm-hmm. He said, I hope I'm not boring y'all with this. No, I'm boring somewhere with this. Because yeah. we still ain't had no dean. So they had us and Tyrone and everybody come to the meeting. Mm-hmm. And six people came to the meeting. And Tyrone said that he don't think nobody's in class to be that was fit to be dean. Mm. Well, when the people heard that, you follow me? They said, well, we'll just choose this guy over here. In the meantime, our dean wasn't coming to class. Sometimes he shows, and every time we get a visitor from L.A. or from Fontana, our dean was not present. So they want to know, what the hell the damn dean? Every time we come here, he ain't never here. Mm-hmm. They went back down there and discussed it again. And they all come to the conclusion, well, Tyrone was the dean, and they needed to also be a dean. You have to, A, have someone who is a dean to vouch for you to be dean. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to give you something. No worries, you got to be provide a reference, saying that you qualify, so on and so forth. Mm-hmm. Next thing I know, I went to the meeting. It was in L.A., the letter was written, and they decided to make me dean. Mm-hmm. Just like that. That's how it happened. For me being dean of the school. Dr. Harris signed the letter. Robert, what's his name? Roger Jackson signed it.
Roger Jackson.
That's how I became dean. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Being dean don't mean a doggone thing. I want you guys to understand that. Mm-hmm. Let me finish. Mm-hmm. You see, then he said, but the point is, now they have a head. When they want to talk to somebody, you know who they want to talk to? They want to talk to the dean. They don't care to talk to nobody else. I don't care what's going on any level. They want to talk to the dean.
Right.
Now, I'm going to tell you before I go on. Now, when you go back into the scriptures, there is a model that has been set up. You see? And the founder, who is the head of the school, he said he was the dean of the universe.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You see? It has nothing to do with personalities.
Yeah.
How much you know and how much you don't know. There was time when some folks became dean who just came to class for 5, 6, 7, 8 months. Matter of fact, Terry Ross, y'all know who he is, right?
Yeah.
Been in class 9 months, but he became dean. Mm-hmm. You know who Terry Ross is, right?
Yeah.
And he's one of the best teachers. I'm talking about from coast to coast.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He was the one that talked to Will about the...
He's the one that talked to Will about was that Lucifer in the garden.
Yeah.
That's who Terry Welch is. He's been here.
Yeah.
And usually when he comes, he makes sure he makes a stop here.
Yeah.
He usually stays with me for about a week or so. I just give him a key and say, y'all go do what y'all want to do. Yeah. And they go and visit all the schools in the area. Mm-hmm. You see? But there hasn't been a model, and that's the founder himself. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You see? Now, he didn't set himself up as dean. I'm talking about Henry Clifford Kennedy. He didn't do that. Mm-hmm. It was Yahweh himself who appeared under the founder. Mm-hmm. You see, and declared him to be the one to go out and carry out this gospel. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about at the end of the age. I mean, of this present kingdom age. Mm-hmm. When Yahweh went to Noah, believe me, Noah's mind his own doggone business.
Right.
You see? He goes to Noah at the end of the age and anoints him to be what? We can call it whatever you want. He was the dean too. Mm-hmm. And what he was preaching was that the founder, or Yahweh himself, appeared unto me in a vision and told me that there is impending doom. That there's going to rain. I'm talking about Noah right now.
Yeah.
You see? And look, Noah had to take that word out. You see? Now let me show you what Noah was dealing with. Before I get go to Genesis, 6th chapter, you see, and just start reading down when you get it. Mm-hmm. Now he chose Noah. Not like Lord want to do this. Come on, man. He don't know about building a doggone boat. Mm-hmm. No ark or whatever. Scooter. What? He don't know nothing about that. I'm talking about Noah building an ark to put the animals in. And his family, and that is going to float like it's supposed to float. Mm-hmm. He ain't seen no damn rain.
That's right. Not there.
But we're talking about Yahweh. With Yahweh, all things are possible. Mm-hmm. That is, if you believe, if you don't believe. Mm-hmm. But Yahweh, he'll make sure you believe when he needs you. Mm-hmm. But we're talking about Noah right now. But I want you to see what Yahweh with Noah was dealing with. He was dealing with the same thing that Moses was dealing with. Mm-hmm. He was dealing with the same thing that Abraham was dealing with. And he was dealing with the same thing that Yahweh was dealing with. He was dealing with the same thing that the Father was dealing with. He was dealing with the same thing that we all are dealing with right now. Talk about Noah. Mm-hmm. Read.
Genesis chapter 6.
Go ahead.
And it came to pass, when men began to multiply on the face of the earth,
mm-hmm.
and daughters were born unto them,
read on,
that the sons of Elohim saw the daughters of men, that they were fair.
Is that 6?
Yep.
Go ahead, read on.
That they were fair.
Read on.
And they took them wives of all which they chose.
Read on.
And Yahweh said, my spirit shall not always strive with man,
mm-hmm.
for he is but flesh.
Uh-huh.
That is day.
That's it. Now he there is but flesh. Mm-hmm. Now you know like I know. When Adam came out of that garden, it wasn't nobody with him but his wife. And they multiplied and they grew in the antediluvian age. Mm-hmm. You see, here come Cain. Here come Cain. You see? And guess what? That spirit, talking about Lucifer, takes up residence in him. Mm-hmm. Or he just hide or cloak himself in the flesh or in a veil. But that's my brother Cain. That's my brother Seth. Mm-hmm. Have no idea that that was Lucifer or Satan in a body. Mm-hmm. You follow me? Like all these red folks running around, I'm talking about these Talibans and the killing folks. I mean, they're called lone wolves, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, that's my friend. I had no idea he had that in his mind. You get my point? But the people grew, and as the people grew, guess what? Their thoughts grew, and it multiplied. And I'm letting you know, they're just dealing with flesh, lies, deception, you understand? Egotism, egos, personalities, all meshed together. That's what we're dealing with. But let's read, Doc. Come on.
Let his days be 120 years.
Read on.
There were Nephilim. And the earth.
Now, King James Version said there were giants.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Holy Name said degenerates.
Degenerates.
Mm-hmm. That's what it said. But there were giants. Mm-hmm. Back here, coming out of that garden.
Right.
Mm-hmm. How do I know that? There were giants up here in Canaan's land.
Okay.
And Canaan's land is a type of heaven, or Jerusalem above.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You see? There are giants.
Yeah.
Got a pattern.
Yeah.
Let's read, please.
And also after that, when the sons of Elohim came in unto the daughters of men,
read on,
and they bare children to them,
read,
the same became mighty men which were old men of renown.
Read on.
And Yahweh say that the wickedness of man was great in the earth.
Now wait a minute. The what?
Yahweh say that wickedness of man.
Now where the hell did that come from? Where did wickedness come from? It's not like you can buy it. Can't purchase no wickedness. Matter of fact, you can't even cook no food to eat to cause you to be wicked. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, somebody would create that by now. Mm-hmm. Ain't nothing you're gonna smoke or drink to cause you to be wicked. Now where'd it come from? Mm-hmm. We got a purpose. We got a pattern operation. And Yahweh is running the show.
That's
you
right.
See? Some folks should say, well, Joe, you called the class before. Hey, class still going on. Different faces. Mm-hmm. Class, we're glad to grow. We've been here, I don't know, even since you've been here, you see the whole new cycle of faces come around. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You see? But keep reading. We're dealing with the flashback here with Noah. Come on now, read.
And that every intent of the thoughts of his heart.
Every intent of what?
His heart was only
evil. The thought of man's heart was evil continually. What are you talking about? This is what I'm talking about here. Your egotistical, misdirected personality. That's what we're dealing with. All man thoughts. Well, I don't like it like that. I want it like this. Oh, man, I want it to. You get my point? Mm-hmm. You see? But my point is, it all started with Adam's fall out of that garden. Mm-hmm. And when he fell, I'm letting you know right now, it looked like he's ashamed right here because it all covered up. But that was Yahweh made manifest. And if he comes down out of that garden, the purpose is within him. How do I know that? Because when Yahweh himself, Elohim, took up residence in that man called Adam, I'm letting you know, the purpose is talked right in him. Likewise, here you come. You see, at the end, you see, I'm talking about when you manifest out of your mother's womb, see, you making an exodus. Mm-hmm. Out of your mom's womb, mm-hmm. into the earth. That's your exodus and that's your beginning on earth. Mm-hmm. Just as Moses made an exodus out of the land of Egypt, you follow me? And then he had a beginning. He went up here and saw the beginning of creation on how to come in. Mm-hmm. But that was his beginning, you see, in the wilderness to worship Yahweh in spirit and in truth. That's what he said. Bring him on this mountain so he can worship me. They weren't worshiping down here, but they most certainly was worshiping around here. And if you didn't, guess what? I'm going to punish you. Because I got a tabernacle I'm going to make. You see, but they had no idea, you see, that that old satanic spirit, you follow me, was out here buffeting them. That's what he's doing. But at the point, that's what Noah was dealing with. Keep reading, please.
And it repented Yahweh that he had made man on the earth.
In other words, it ticked him off. Mm-hmm. Like, why did I do this? But you know what? It's my show. Mm-hmm. I'm Yahweh. I can handle this. Mm-hmm. Ain't no surprise to me. But see, keep in mind, Noah, you see, is repeating what he saw in the vision to the Pharisees, to the scribes. Mm-hmm. Right. But it was Joshua, the son of Nun, who narrated the Genesis as they're coming on out of the garden.
Right.
You see? And he's letting Moses know that Yahweh didn't like that. Mm-hmm. And if he chose what he could, he would have just took him out. Can't do that. Because if he did that, then he would not be a just Ale. Right. Because even Yahweh was subject to his own law. You follow me? It's just that when Joshua, son of Nun, was made manifest, he didn't violate not any one of the law. He kept every tenet of the law. Nevertheless, this is what we did. This is what Noah's dealing with. Come on, let's read, please.
And it grieved him at his heart.
And it grieved you, Noah?
Yahweh.
It grieved Yahweh, but it also grieved Noah. Who do you think that was? Mm-hmm. I don't want no doggone. Come on, folks. I don't want anybody to get on the ark with me. Gonna try to kick me off the dock. You know what I mean? I'm steering it up as you gonna just, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Keep on reading.
And Yahweh said, I will destroy man.
I got destroyed. Now this will reveal to Noah. Come on.
From the face of the earth.
Read.
Both man and beast.
This is the vision.
And the creeping things.
Read.
And the birds of heaven.
Read on.
For it repented.
Oh, that's so much.
That I have made.
In other words, the conditions at the end of the age gotta be same as the beginning, the condition at the beginning of the age. Mm-hmm. There was darkness at the beginning, there gotta be darkness at the end. Right. I'm going to paint the ark pitch black within and black without. Because there was darkness right in the beginning.
Yeah.
You see, in other words, I want to make an upper deck, a middle deck, and a lower deck because I am the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the man is made spirit, soul, and body.
Okay.
All mankind was in this ark because at the end of the age, all mankind got to be in that ark.
Yeah.
Got a pattern.
That's right.
You see?
That's right.
And coming out of that garden, death reigned from Adam all the way down to Moses. Mm-hmm. I go all the way down to the cross.
Yeah.
You see? Because, remember, when he said death ran from Adam to Moses, he's not talking about the man Moses. You understand what I'm saying?
That's right.
Oh, okay.
That's right.
Hold your finger, boss. Read where you at right now. What's great? What's great?
8 verse.
Read down to 11 and pick up real quickly Romans 5 and 12. But read down where you read on down where you left off. You gotta make a point. Read on.
But Noah found grace in the eyes of Yahweh.
Read that. Did Yahweh find grace in the eyes, or did Noah find grace in the eyes? Go ahead on. Go ahead, read on.
Sorry, Noah.
There you go.
These are the generations of Noah.
Read on.
Noah was a just man and upright in his generation.
Come on, read on.
Noah walked with Elohim.
Read on.
And Noah begat 3 sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth.
Mm-hmm.
The earth also was corrupt before Elohim.
Right, read on.
And the earth was filled with violence.
That's it right there. The earth was filled with violence.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that all what's going on right now?
Yeah.
The earth is filled with violence.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Ain't nothing changing.
Yeah.
You see? But Noah was the head.
Mm-hmm.
He was the front man calling the shots. We're going to build an ark. Mm-hmm. It's going to be like this. It's going to be an upper deck, a middle deck, and a lower deck. And Yahweh himself has given me divine specifications on how to build and construct that ark. Now listen. Oh, there's so much. I know I call the scripture. What did I call right there?
5 and 12.
Okay.
5 and 12.
We're going to hold that for just a second. And pick up real quick, 2 Peter 3 and 8. Mac it back it up to 3 and 3. But what I want you to know is this. See, this boy, this is a picture illustration.
Mm-hmm.
But this picture illustration is no more than this man right here. I hope I can find him. I know it's up here. Here? Is it here? I know it's here. You know how the satanic he likes to hide. That boy always likes to hide. I know it's here. Oh, here we go, right here. Here we go. This is what he is. You see? He's just a freaking liar. That's what he is.
Mm-hmm.
And what a lie does, it gives birth to dishonesty and deception.
Mm-hmm.
You see? Envy gives birth to what? Hatred and rage.
Yeah.
Evil gives birth to murder. And malice.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Unrighteousness.
Mm-hmm.
You see, I could say OJ, huh? But anyway, I didn't mean it like that. But y'all get the point. It's the same thing. You see? Mm-hmm. But you get the point.
Yeah.
That's what he is. He is just a perversion.
Mm-hmm.
He's a perversion of righteous principles.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. It. And you know what his problem is? He always get his egotistical, misdirected personality in the way. Boom! That's it right there. That's the image. This is the image of the beast, and that's you.
Mm-hmm.
Thinking you know more about than Yahweh. What I want, what I feel. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You in the way.
Mm-hmm.
Your thoughts, your theories, your concepts. That's the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
That's what stunts your growth. So now, Noah has to contend with the thoughts of mankind that was evil continually.
Mm-hmm.
That's what Noah had to contend with. And there is violence in the land. So Noah had to contend with that too.
Mm-hmm.
Likewise, Moses put it lightly. He said, the people, these people were stiff-necked and always murmuring.
Yeah.
That's what he would say.
Uncircumcised.
Uncircumcised in their hearts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Aaron said, Moses, you know how these people are.
Right.
You know how they are. Can't tell them nothing. Ain't nothing changed. That's what I'm trying to get you to see. It was going on here. It was going on here. It has to go on here. And it better go on right now.
Right.
Why? It's a pattern. And that's how we know who you are and where you're coming from.
Mm-hmm.
You got that scripture, Doc?
I got it.
Let's read. Oh, did we ever get caught?
No. You want that?
We'll get back to that. I can talk about that end, because my wife set me straight.
2 Peter 3.
I mean, she set me so straight.
Mm-hmm.
I'm scared straight.
Mm-hmm.
And she was a Gentile or an Egyptian.
Mm-hmm.
You get the point?
Uh-huh.
No, she didn't go to class.
Yeah.
But she understood principles. Let's read.
2 Peter 3 and 3.
Read on.
Knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers.
Scoffers. Read on.
Walking after their own lusts.
Read on.
And saying, where is the promise of his coming?
Read on.
For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation.
Read on.
For this thou willing are ignorant of that by the
now,
word.
Now, you know what the scoffers is all about, right? Here's Noah building an ark.
Right.
And let me say, now, he wasn't the only one building. He had sons, and folks came and helped him.
Yeah.
But you know, there are some folks say, look at that damn fool over there building a doggone ark. Mm-hmm. You know, damn well, he ain't seen no doggone rain. It ain't never rain. Matter of fact, what is it? He's almost going to rain. I'll be damned if I go and pick up a nail or pick up a piece of wood or anything to help Noah out. Damn, he must be psychologically unbalanced. He's off his rocket. Build a doggone ark. Talk about he heard, got a message from El Shaddai. Mm-hmm. And it say Yahweh.
That's right.
And it say Yahweh.
Yeah.
But see, since Noah narrated Genesis, he said Yahweh.
Yeah, right.
Because he understood as he's narrated Genesis, you see, to the people who asked him, what's up?
Yeah. Yeah.
You see? Never, this is what we're dealing with. You see? Now let's read.
For this they willing are ignorant of that by the word of Yahweh.
Now look. Ha ha! Look at this fool.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't even help bring it word. You know what I'm saying? Now my point is, this is what the kind of people we're dealing with.
Mm-hmm.
Carnal minded, misdirected personalities, egotistical. Mm-hmm. Misdirected personalities.
Mm-hmm.
This is the image we deal with. Well, I ain't going down to the cloud. I'm like, what the hell he said?
Mm-hmm.
That kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Well, you think he's so-and-so. Well, who the hell you think you are?
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't like the way he did this. But you get my point?
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying it's nothing but flesh, man. And I ain't talking about this.
Yeah.
I'm talking about what you entertain your the perverted. Know how to love and give and share of yourself.
Right.
Never, that's what Noah was dealing with. But my point is, Noah was the head or he was the dean. Not the president, not the vice president. He was the head. And he had to contend with those evil thoughts of mankind continually and the violence that prevailed at that particular time. Just like we got to deal with the same thing. You're going to stand alone by yourself. You know Yahshua Messiah, he's still all alone and all by himself.
That's right.
Even to the ones who call themselves loving. I'm talking about the ones he raised the dead, healed the sick, called the blind to see, the dumb to speak, and the deaf to hear. Guess what? They said what? Crucify him! Crucify him!
Mm-hmm.
For what?
Barabbas.
What the hell did he do?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when the one that sits on the seat of authority, and at that time I'm talking about Rome, they say, I can't find no fault with him.
Yeah.
But you know what they said? Crucify him! Crucify him!
Mm-hmm.
Innocent blood. But y'all was already set up and prepared. Y'all always set that up.
Mm-hmm.
You see? He created his own acceptable sacrifice. But they thought that was Joseph and Mary's boy. Looks just like one of us. You get the point.
Right.
All right? Let's read.
For this they willing are ignorant of that by the word of Yahweh the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water.
In other words, they know anything about the beginning. The earth standing in the water and out of the water. Nevertheless, the conditions are the same in the beginning as they were with Noah at the end of the age.
Mm-hmm.
There was animals in the beginning, so there had to be animals coming back in the ark.
Yeah.
They came in two by two here, they come out two by two here.
Yeah.
Male and female, you see, enter in that ark, you see, male and female were presenting themselves to Adam, if that makes any sense. You see, and listen, Adam in that garden, whether you like it or not, he is king and high priest. He is also the mediator, you see, and he was the one that was telling everybody what to do, where to go, and how to do, because Yahweh put that in him.
Yeah.
Talking about Adam.
Yeah.
He don't want to tell Eve, don't touch the tree.
Mm-hmm.
Just like you tell your kids, don't go in the refrigerator.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you go outside. You better go to bed. Turn off that TV.
Mm-hmm.
You see, As soon as you ain't looking, they got to look see where you are. Guess what? They start doing their own. That's what they do.
Yeah.
Why? Because of that misdirected egotistical terminology, egotistical misdirected personality, the image that they embrace, that they've taken on.
Mm-hmm.
You see? That's what we're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm through with that. Now, look up the word cult. And then we'll go to that other scripture that I call. Because I called another scripture, did I not?
Yeah. Romans 5:4.
I want to address that about death reign from Adam to Noah. But not the man Noah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Which I'm going to draw that out in a second for you. But I've got to look at the word cult because I wouldn't do this any good. I'd be misrepresenting my ex-wife.
I mean,
cult.
Cult.
Yeah.
From formal religious veneration.
Uh-huh.
Worship.
Read.
2, a system of religious beliefs and ritual, also its body of adherents.
Read.
3, a religion regarded as unorthodox or spurious.
Now, look, we aren't orthodox. This is a, this is a revolutionary teaching, right?
Yeah.
That encompasses cosmogony, eschatology, philosophy, anatomy, and just what he said.
Yeah, science, all that.
Nobody else teach you the way we do.
That's right.
Read on, please.
4, a system for cure of disease
based
on dogma set forth by its promulgator.
Read on. No, wait. Set up by what?
Dogma.
Based on a system for the cure of disease based on dogma set forth by its promulgator.
Okay, read on.
5, a great devotion to a person, idea, or thing.
Now that's what got me right there.
Idea.
That's what got me right there. A great devotion to a what?
A great devotion to a person.
At that time where I was, it was Lynn Kelly. And I'm going to tell you right now, they will kill you, some folks in there, about even coming near Lynn Kelly. I'm not talking about tell you what they're going to do. They will do it.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's how strong the kind of power he had.
That's right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Dad. I would never call him Dad. I just couldn't do it.
We know.
I never called him Dad.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I called him Glenn.
Yeah.
But everybody else, Dad said this, and Dad said that. And Dad said this, and Dad said that. Dad said, you need to have some kids. You know what? They have some kids.
They see what I'm saying?
I ain't lying to you, I was there.
Yeah.
Kisses ring and everything.
Yeah.
Dad said it.
I'm telling you, I was there.
Mm-hmm.
I want a TV. You know what? He got a TV. We paid his rent. We gave him, paid him a salary. And I'm going to tell you something. I'm one of the few ones. I made sure he had money in his pocket.
Mm-hmm. I did too.
I want nobody to know. I just slipped a little thing here.
Show
him
here.
That's what I did.
Yeah.
That's what I did, because I know he didn't work, and I loved to hear him teach. And we all agreed that we're going to take him, stop him from working, and just preach full time. We had a vote. My hand went right on up too. I wasn't worshiping, but I had no problem with donating. But what about pumping him up? I'm talking about myself only. It was about making sure he preached. Not paying aside, but the school had to have lights and all that kind of stuff. But on the side, I slipped a little something. That's what I did.
Yeah.
My wife knew that.
Okay.
And she came to some of the functions, and she saw how everybody just, you know, he's sitting on the throne, and everybody like the Don. Everybody come around there, and they mouth wide open.
Yeah.
And Dad would just teach. And whatever Dad said, you better do. And if you don't, guess what? Everybody gonna throw rocks at your bad butt.
Sound familiar.
That's what they did. I know where I was. I'm looking at this thing and I'm sitting thinking, when she said that, I couldn't say nothing. Not one word. Because I know he'll tell him a lie. I'm gonna tell you what he would say. If you leave class, you won't live 1 year. And I'm just making out whatever he told me, and he would tell them a lie so they'll stay in class. Otherwise they'll leave class.
I know where he got it from. I know where Snellbagger got it from.
That's what he told me, that I'll take him lunch. And I'm saying something, I would ask questions. Talking about me.
Yeah.
just to create a little, not chaos, but to stir up the pot to get him to talk about certain things.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So people looked at me like I was a renegade. Mm-hmm. But the point I'm trying to make is, whatever he said, that's how it was. No if buts about it. Mm-hmm. One thing he did not do, he says, I do not run the school. He did, but he didn't. Mm-hmm. Whatever y'all, he'll tell you what he thinks you should do, but y'all can do what y'all want to do. And if you do what you want to do, and you do what I thought, you do what I told you to do, I told you this, and I told you that. And next thing, next time they see something, they do exactly what he say do. Mm-hmm. But he always stayed away.
Yeah.
But the point is, one more time.
A great devotion to a person, idea, or thing. Such devotion regarded as literary or intellectual fad.
Now you know good and well, we feel like Elohim, the archetype pattern, is nothing better than that. Mm-hmm. You know we teach that there's nothing, this is a school of the highest learning.
Right.
And it is. Mm-hmm. But the man isn't. That's the point I'm trying to get you to see.
Yeah.
And this is what folks was looking at. They propped him up here, and we made a trip to Pomona one day. Mm-hmm. We all said, well, come together.
Right.
Because Glenn and Snellbaker, they were like this.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
But they decided they're going to come together. We're going to go to school. We're going to kind of reconcile, you know, bury the hatchet. And we all made plans. Mm-hmm. We're going to come to Pomona. Because they can house everybody comfortably.
That's right.
You see? And that Andre South is going to be the first speaker. Dana Julaw going to be the second speaker. Glenn going to be the third speaker. And Leonard going to be the last. That was planned months, weeks before we even had class. Mm-hmm. And everybody just, let me tell you something. Everybody was there. Everybody from the schools. And we all think of Pasadena is waiting for this fight. Because we know how Glenn teach. And I'm telling you, he's good.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's good.
He's good.
His father said this, he's the best when he's right. Mm-hmm. That's what he said, he's the best when he's right.
That's from Charles Leonard.
You see?
Glenn.
Now, my point is this, it's all set. Mm-hmm. You had to worry about who's going to speak, you know you wasn't. That's the point I'm trying to make. Mm-hmm. These were the four speakers.
Yeah.
Right.
We get there, Andre's teaches, class is just going beautiful. First speaker gets up, Andre, doing good. Dennis gets up, he gives a good lecture. Everybody's feeling good, the choir's singing. Mm-hmm. You follow me? Next thing I know, it's Glenn time to teach. Next thing I know, they're back in the room, they fighting and arguing in the damn room.
Yeah, we in the office.
We had no idea, we out there enjoying the choir. Mm-hmm. The singing and everything, fellowshipping. They out there, we're down in the room. We had no idea what was going on. This guy comes out after 2 hours and say, class is over with. Your dean had made a decision that he wants to go last. Mm. And he did not want to go third. Mm. And so since we're not going to stick with the original rules, class is over with. It's been 2 hours.
Whoa. That's it.
Split.
Wow.
That's it. We go back to Pasadena. Let me show you what I'm talking about. I'm taking it somewhere. Mm-hmm. We just have a good class. Here comes some folks from Pomona. Mm-hmm. Forget his name. David Woody and his wife.
Mm-hmm. Melissa
was... No, maybe one other patient. This is my point. Next thing I know, Glenn starts teaching. David Woody and his wife, they start arguing with Glenn. They going at it like this. And I peeked over to one of the people, one of the class members. I said, look at your Yahweh right there. Look at Dad. Mm-hmm. I said, now that's what I'm talking about for this reason. They said, oh, Joe, your problem. Oh, you don't believe Glenn is Yahweh. Mm-hmm. I said, I believe it's Yahweh. Mm-hmm. But I don't believe I have to get it from only him, mm-hmm. like you guys do. Because mm-hmm. folks start saying, if you don't get it from me, you ain't getting it from nobody.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Glenn said it. Leonard said it. Mm-hmm. Jonesy said it. What's his name?
Rachel.
Yeah, they all said it. Mm-hmm. And they saying it down there now. Mm-hmm. And I'm letting you know, every last one of them got to fall. Mm-hmm. All of them got to fall.
Mm-hmm.
When you start talking like that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. When you think you're so high and mighty, I'm letting you know, Yahweh going to bring you on down. Mm-hmm. That's just what he does. Mm-hmm. You see, because everybody's looking at the man, the physical, natural man, the flesh. And you can say anything you want to say. You see, oh, there's so much. I want to make this point, and then I want to go to this other point. 2 Timothy 4:1. Now, this is what I was told to teach ever since I came into class, from every speaker to every guy up. This is what they said. Read, please. You're a little rusty. You'll be fine. Yeah. You'll be fine. You're just a little rusty right now. But the voice is the same.
The voice?
Oh, yeah. He got that commercial voice. One of those voices you read when you want to tell a story.
2 Timothy 4:1.
Now read. Now, this is the Apostle Paul.
I charge thee.
Now, wait a minute. He says, I'm charging you.
Therefore.
Wait a minute. That's all of us in the room who claim to know. Now, we're talking about those who don't know.
Yeah.
We're talking about those who claim to know. Read, please.
I charge thee.
Read.
Therefore, before Yahweh.
Read on.
And the Savior, Yahshua the Messiah.
And I'm letting you know how it is. Read, please.
Who shall judge the quick and the dead and
read.
Disappear.
Now, Paul's letting you know where he stands. He let you know who's running the show. Read, please.
Preach the word.
He said, preach the word. Hey, listen. Don't preach what you feel and what you think and how it should be and what shall Yahweh showed you. Don't lean to your own understanding.
Yeah.
If you can't put it on a pattern, you ain't got no business teaching. And we got a philosophy in this school. You can preach anything you want as long as you can prove it by the pattern.
Right. Uh-huh.
You can't prove it by the pattern. I'm letting you know somebody's going to get up behind you at some point and straighten that principle out. Because it's conjecture. If it's conjecture, it ain't by the pattern. You with me so far? It has to be sound. Read on, please.
Be instant in season.
Be instant in season.
And out of season.
What does that mean? Hey, preach the gospel in class and out of class. Be the gospel in class and out of class. You see? Because by the way you walk, people looking at you.
Right.
You follow what I'm saying? And you're supposed to represent Yahshua Messiah.
Yeah.
Let's read.
Reprove.
Wait a minute. When you read, don't even prove it again. It means to rebuke it. If it ain't right. Read, please.
Rebuke, exhort with all long suffering.
What do you mean exhort? Warn the people. Tell them about Yahshua Messiah. Read, please.
For the time will come.
Read on.
When they will not endure sound doctrine.
Now, and that's going on right now. The time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine.
Yeah.
That's what's going on right now.
That's it.
Hallelujah.
First, there was two Adams. That's one thing. Then, how was it? The reach back principle. Adam's red. His name, they didn't call him Yahshua, they called him Emmanuel. This is what we got now. You see? And now, it ain't the Holy Spirit, it's a birth son. Y'all don't tell me you ain't heard that one.
Right.
You have to have a birth son in you.
You only can get it from there.
A birth son. Now that suggests that there's more than one. You got to get one of these birth sons in you. And I've heard this, that most do not have a birth son. Well, I asked a question, what's the difference between a birth son and a Holy Spirit? It's the same thing. I said, can't be. Can't be. See, there's only one Spirit, there's only one Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of the Spirit of Truth, which is Yahshua or Yahweh Himself. But when you tell me I have to get one of these birth sons or one of these angels in you, who is a birth son, I have a problem with that. That language, that nomenclature, that vernacular. I have a problem with that vernacular. Because that's not common. That's not what the founder taught.
Right.
What the founder taught, what the Holy Spirit in you, is your only hope of glory, not a birth son.
Right.
Now, if you say a birth son is Yahshua Messiah, and Yahshua Messiah in you is your only hope of glory, I'm okay with that. But there is not, he's the only one that there is. There's not a bunch of birth sons running around.
That's right.
Now you have to be born again, and you are a son of Yahweh.
Right.
And the spirit of truth has to be preached. You see? But I'm letting you know that the spirit of the Elohim is already in you. Not getting it, already is. Mm-hmm. But you got to wake up and smell the coffee and realize what it is.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
That's in you.
That's right.
And that is the Messiah in you. Is your only hope. Not getting in, mm-hmm. but already in. Who else gonna stand?
Yeah.
Save him in you. Mm-hmm. That's how you die. See, when you ain't dead, you know what? You got to walk around a swagger. Mm-hmm. Not sure about how it is. Like you know what the hell you talking about. Read, please.
For the time will come when they will not endure sound.
That's going on. Look, I can go on. We don't need charts anymore. Mm-hmm. That's what they teach now. You don't need it. Then why you got them up? We don't need a textbook no more. What did they say?
Yeah.
It's just a reference book. Go ahead, ma'am.
Well, do they ever have new students?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. And how, I mean, you have to use the charts in order to teach them.
They use the charts. They all use the charts.
All of them do.
That's not the point they're making. They think that folks think that there's salvation in the charts.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling you right now, I'm not that damn shallow.
Mm-hmm. Right.
They think that there's salvation in the charts.
Mm-hmm. Right.
They're just tools.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But the problem is that we can use these tools to check you.
Right.
And if I don't have the tools to check you, you can say whatever you want. The transcript, don't even read them. Don't even read them. Don't read the Bible, don't read the textbook, don't read them. Because now Dr. Kennedy said things that is in opposition of what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
That's the problem. See, now folks in Pomona saying, go back and get the newsletter. You read that newsletter?
Mm-hmm.
What Doc said? Hell yeah, I read them all. Yes, go ahead.
Dr. Kennedy himself said, with this teaching, you want to go to heaven?
I hope you get there. You want to go to hell?
I hope you get there.
Yes.
Too. With this same teaching?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, we got this. You don't need the charts. You don't need the Bible. You don't need the textbook. You don't need transcripts. We're revelating now.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's been taught. Mm-hmm. That's no secret. We all heard it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we're going to hang on to Elohim, the Archetype Original Pattern Universe. And I'm telling the founder said he gave us enough. He preached enough to save the whole world.
Yeah.
We got enough to deal with.
I taught you everything you need to know.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's it.
So my point is, as long as you stick with the pattern, and my point is, and this is what we used to say. Prove all things and hold fast to that which is good. Make me prove it to your satisfaction.
Right.
Your satisfaction may be a little bit stronger than Irene's satisfaction.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm saying right now, her satisfaction, she got a strong appetite. I'm talking about Irene.
Mm-hmm.
You can't just tell her any old thing. She knows what she's listening for. And when she came back to class, this is what she said. You can tell me what you're... She said, I heard the music.
Mm-hmm.
The sound of the music of blood, water, spirit for you. Now she understands what that is, and she's moved on.
Mm-hmm.
She realized blood for the fear ain't gonna save her. She realized that the Holy Spirit is gonna save her. Not that she didn't know it then. And there's more to it than blood, water, spirit, for it.
Mm-hmm.
And we all have grown. I'm talking about in Yahshua Messiah, using blood, water, spirit, 40, and as a foundation and going up. When I mean by blood, water, spirit, 40, I'm talking about there's a 50. And the 50 is the holy place. See, in the holy place, you have light, which is enlightenment. You have bread, which is sustenance, which you partake of.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have a mediator, which is the Messiah in you, that is teaching you
right.
about what so-and-so is saying, making you understand what the matter is.
Mm-hmm.
That's 50. And then the 60. That's the sixth step in your tabernacle, which is tearing the veil down so you can see who's sitting on the throne.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we're doing.
That's right.
And then the 70 is you saying, I see it, I'm in the rest. I got it. I understand it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be a witness for Yahshua the Messiah.
Mm-hmm.
You see? Now, this is one that folks still got. Keep reading. I got a couple more verses on that right there.
But after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers, having engineers.
Read on.
And they shall turn away their ears from the truth.
They're going to turn away their ears from the truth. Read on.
And shall be turned unto fables.
No. This is what folks say about us. Well, you're not teaching the family taught that. It's not. They're not wrong. Can't say that. But we're progressing. We're moving on past that.
Right.
Like we talk in the dark ages. Stuck off on some line. I don't know what we're talking about. As soon as we say something, they don't understand. You know what? They're going to start chucking rocks.
Yeah.
That's what folks do. And that's fine. But that's good enough right there. Now, Romans 5 and 12. I'm going to make a point. Now, I made this statement. And let me tell you something right now. Folks still do this. Read, please. Romans 5 and 12. Now, this is the Apostle Paul in his age. And this is what he said.
Five and twelve. Wherefore? As by one man sin entered into the world.
Now that man was Adam. All right. Let's read, please.
And death by sin. And so death passed upon all men. For they all have sinned. For until the law.
Talking about the Mosaic law. Okay. Read on.
Sin was in the world.
Sin was in the world. Before the law was set up, sin was already in the world.
Yeah.
Because sin is the transgression of the law, right?
Right.
Let's read on, please.
But sin is not imputed when there is no law.
In other words, you ain't guilty of nothing if the rule ain't been set up.
Nevertheless.
Read.
Death reigned from Adam to Moses.
Mm-hmm. Now, most people think the man Moses, correct? Mm-hmm. That's not what he's talking about.
Right.
What he's talking about is the dispensation.
That's right.
Of Noah.
That's right.
Hebrews 11 and 1. Now we know, when you get it, just start reading. Adam died. You got it?
Yes.
Go ahead, read on.
Now faith is the substance of things hoped for.
Uh-huh.
The evidence of things not seen.
In short, that's Yahshua Messiah.
Mm-hmm.
Read on, please.
For by it the elders obtained a good report.
What do you mean, the elders? I'm talking about Yahshua Messiah, the Holy Spirit. He taught them all. Let's read.
Through faith we understand that the ages were ordained by the word of Elohim.
Now it says by faith, hold it right there, the age was ordained. King James Version says the ages were framed.
Yeah.
Like a window frame.
Mm-hmm.
You see? So when you look here, you see these ages was framed. Mm-hmm. Like a window.
Yeah.
It is framed. You see that? Framed just like a window. You know, you can look in or you can look out.
Mm-hmm.
But what we're doing, we're looking back into the purpose.
Mm-hmm.
So you see that Adam died instantaneously in his consciousness, right?
Yeah.
Spiritually so.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But he also lived 930 years in the flesh, right?
Mm-hmm.
930 years, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then he died. Physically so.
Mm-hmm.
Right? For Yahweh talked to Adam, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why? Yahweh is the only one that opens and closes the ages and dispensations.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And he does that through a man. So when Adam died, the dispensation of Adam was still going on until he talked to Noah. You see? And when he talked to Noah, the dispensation of Adam closed.
Right.
And he opened up that dispensation with Noah.
Hmm.
And we know that Noah lived, was 480 years old when Yahweh appeared to him and gave him the vision.
Yeah.
We also know that he preached for 120 years. And at the age of 600, was the year of the flood.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Which is 2348, which we ain't got time to get into. But it's right here on the chart right here. You see, 2348, that is the year of the flood.
Mm-hmm.
Counting backwards from 4,000. You with me so far?
Yeah.
But my point is, he was 600 years old, the year of the flood. Now we also know that Noah lived 350 years on this side of the flood and the post-diluvian age after closing out the antediluvian age. You see, and he died, he was 950 years old. All right?
Mm-hmm.
But when he died, the dispensation of Noah was still going on.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You see, until he talked to Abraham. Mm-hmm. Now, when he talked to Abraham, Abraham was 75 years old when he told him to give from all his kindred.
Right.
Right? And listen, he was 99 years old when Yahweh told him he got to have a kid.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Was 99? Yeah. I think that's what it was. Well, look, he was 90 years old when he was able to bear fruit. Mm-hmm. But he was 100 years old when Isaac was born.
Yeah.
You with me so far?
Uh-huh.
Now, we know that Abraham lived to be 175 years old. You see? And listen, in that time frame, he had two sons by Sarah, Ishmael and Isaac. Mm-hmm. And from Ishmael and Isaac come Esau and Jacob, of course, from Jacob come the 12 sons of Israel, or the son of Jacob, or the Israelites, or the Hebrews.
Mm-hmm.
And when Abraham died, he was 175 years old, but before that, he also had another wife, Keturah,
yeah.
And had 8 kids with her.
Mm-hmm.
And Midian was the 4th kid, which was Jethro Ruel come from. You see?
Oh, okay.
The Midianites.
Mm-hmm.
In the land of Midian. Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what I'm trying to say, he died at 175 years old. But the dispensation of Abraham was still going on. He closed out that dispensation with Noah. And open up with Abraham, and then when Abraham died, the dispensation of Abraham was still going on. And then Yahweh spoke to Moses, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we know that Moses was born down the land of Egypt, right? You see? And listen, we also know that he come through the dividing waters of the Red Sea, mm-hmm. into the wilderness out there for 40 years, right? For 40 years. Because he was 8 years old when Yahweh told him, gave him the vision, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he died, everybody knows that, out in Mount Nebo, right?
Yeah.
And we all know that he was 120 years old
right.
when he died.
Correcto?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 120 years old. But the dispensation of Moses was still going on all the way down to the cross.
Mm-hmm.
And after the cross, the dispensation of Moses was ended. Because now, a new age was being ushered in. Because see, when Moses came, that was the dispensation of the law. Prior to that, that was the dispensation of faith with Abraham. So when the dispensation of faith came to an end, you see, the dispensation of the law took place when Yahweh spoke to Moses. And we know that Yahshua came in to fulfill that law and to nail that law to the cross.
Right.
Why? Because we're dealing with a stiff-necked, uncircumcised people, the white wall sepulchers, or a generation of vipers.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And in short, we're just dealing with the flesh, the image of the man. The same stiff-necked folks that Noah was dealing with way back there.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to take it any further back, guess what? Cain was worse than all of them.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Y'all hear about that kid? That 16-year-old just finally confessed that he killed his brother down in San Diego. Menifee. The kid came up missing.
Oh, yeah.
Kid came up missing, but the brother killed him.
You're right. I'm
but he just couldn't bear it. And he came clean and said, listen, I killed my brother and told him where to bury him.
Right. Yeah.
Now, why would you do something like that? I'm going to tell you exactly why. Egotistical, misdirected personality. I want it. I don't like it. Got to be this way.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't this. It ain't that. This is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's the flesh.
It's the flesh.
Only thing Lucifer is, he is an angel with the carnal mind. He is a woman just like you. How do I know that? Because there ain't but one man.
Ain't but one man.
And that is Yahshua Messiah. Everybody else is the bride.
Mm-hmm.
To prove that, he formed a man from the dust of the earth and got up in him. And then he gave birth to the woman just like he gave birth to Virgin Mother Earth.
Yeah.
And just like this Virgin Mother Earth, and that then here come we, she is also come from Virgin Mother Earth.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And at that time, there had been no sin committed on the earth, right? Mm-hmm. Just like there was no sin or no transgression committed when Adam came in. Mm-hmm. Nevertheless, that's the parent substance. In other words, I'll say it like this. This is the archetype for the original pattern of the universe. But Adam is the first archetype physical man on the earth. Can't say it any better than that. And we were all in him.
Right.
Mm-hmm. We all lived in him before we died in him. Mm-hmm. And when we died in him, guess what? We have this egotistical, misdirected personality just like the founder before the vision. Mm-hmm. And if you just hold on to Yahshua Messiah, you see, and receive, you see, the grace of Yahweh, you see, I'm telling you something, that's what makes you free. 1 Corinthians 15 and 1, and read down, and we're done. Now, this is what the Apostle Paul said in his age. Because he, too, had an egotistical, misdirected personality. Mm-hmm. How do I know that? He was killing all the damn Jews.
Right.
And listen, by permission, too. Somebody say, well, see, he murdered Yahshua Messiah they killed him for murder and sedition, right? Mm-hmm. Because he took on Barabbas.
Right.
Transgressions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which he had none on. But they said, what? He's the one that they say he's the king of the Jews.
Mm-hmm.
They say he's better than Caesar.
Tear that temple
down. You follow me? So since he's better than Caesar, hey, what sedition is talking against the government. Mm-hmm. Like communism.
Mm-hmm.
So what, you know? Crucified. He ain't better than Caesar. Mm-hmm. So after he dies, you follow what I'm saying? Here comes Stephen. Mm-hmm. Paul had permission to stone Stephen. Now this is a pictorial illustration of a dragon. Mm-hmm. You with me so far? But that dragon is a representation of the Roman Empire.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now if you take this dragon, that's the same dragon that's after the woman, and Stephen is the woman.
Mm-hmm.
Had you been here, they might have stoned you too. Mm-hmm. Talk about Yahshua Messiah. Give up to you. You know what I'm saying? That's what happened with James and Peter. Mm-hmm. You see, James, they cut his neck off. Peter went, oh, we'll deal with later. We're going to put him in jail.
Yeah.
You see, that's the plate 36 over there. I mean, not 36, but 35. I think, is that 35? But Cain set up his city because that's the capital of the earth.
Right.
You see, first Babylonian Empire, second Babylonian Empire, of course, with Nebuchadnezzar.
Mm-hmm.
The Medes and the Persians.
Three.
Okay. You got Alexander the Great with the, you follow me? Mm-hmm. With the Greeks.
Mm-hmm. Four.
You see? And then you got pagan Rome. You with me so far?
Mm-hmm.
Which is represented by Rome right here.
Mm-hmm.
The Jews. And that little peak up there representing the Gentiles, because the Gentiles was also part of the promise. Mm-hmm. Then you got that dragon up there. See that dragon up there? That is pagan Rome.
Mm-hmm.
Right up there. That's pagan Rome. And this big bad boy here, that is the Roman Empire.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about the papacy.
Yeah.
You see, that's going on right now.
Mm-hmm.
So you got that dragon looking almost like this dragon right here and that dragon.
Mm-hmm.
Same one. What I'm talking about, I'm saying that is pagan Rome. And listen, there was persecuting Messiah for murder and sedition. You see? So guess what? Here you come along. Now we all being persecuted. You know why? Because we're preaching with Dr. Kelly talk.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody want to talk to us, want to come see us, only one of them visit us.
Mm-hmm.
Still love us. Mm-hmm. Don't worry about them. Don't even argue with, don't even fight with, don't even talk to them. You know why? Because you get exposed.
Mm-hmm.
And when folks get exposed, they want to fight.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They want to fight, start calling crazy, you know what I mean? Because they expose.
Yeah.
I just let them turn flips now.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you do. Because the reality is this. Once you realize this is you, the image that you've embraced since you've been walking around in this earth plane, when you realize that, it is Yahshua Sai that revealed that to you, the rock. And that rock is going to shatter this image, get you out of the way, and allow you to see who you really are. It's not Joe, but it's Yahshua the Messiah. It's Yahweh himself in the personality of Joe Williams. As Paul says, I die, not I, but the Messiah in me. You on this earth live your life through Yahshua the Messiah. You are manifesting the Father's will through your body. You are the Son of Yahweh carrying out his purpose through your flesh. Not this flesh. You see? So you're going to manifest both mysteries. And I'm down. You see? The mystery of righteousness and the mystery of unrighteousness. So that you can see that it's Yahweh running the whole show. And when you understand that, it brings about peace. Like I told Reggie, don't go over there and fight with those people. Just preach. Don't try to make them understand. Just tell them. It's up to them to understand.
That's right.
And don't try to make them. Just tell them. It's up to them to understand. And when it's their time, I'm letting you know y'all will reveal it. Hallelujah.
That concludes tonight's lecture. We have classes here Sundays, 11 to 1. Tuesdays and Fridays, 7:30, 9:30. Any announcements?
No.
All Denise could be having Dr. Rima Ramirez. I saw Stan have a doxology. Be dismissed. Now to him is able to keep you from falling, present you falling with his presence with exceeding joy. To all the wise Elohim, our Savior, the Yahshua Sarah Sovereign, who have glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both for all time, now and ever, is all so.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
What the heck is that? It's not the battery, is it? No, I changed the batteries.
Excuse me.